Hello, this is Michael with the Windows Club. If you're new to Windows 10, or maybe just new to the PC, you might be overwhelmed. In this video, we will cover some basic tips for using Windows 10. Now, as a caveat, in many of the things we cover, there are multiple ways to do almost anything in Windows. These steps we offer will be what could be considered the fastest or at least the easiest to remember. So, let's start by learning how to log in. When you power up your computer, you're brought to the login screen. The PC will ask you to unlock the screen and then sign on. You just click on your name and type in your password, or in my case, your PIN. If it is just you on the computer, you will just see your name in the lower left-hand corner. If there are more than one user on the computer, then you will see a list of all of the users. So if it is not your name at the center of the screen when you log in, just click on the right one. So let's take a quick look at the buttons on the right to become familiar with it. We of course have the power button, which is what it says, power, off, on, restart. Ease of access. From here, you can have it to where the computer will actually read to you what's on the screen. You can magnify what's going on in the screen to make anything bigger. High contrast, sticky keys, this in case you hit more than one or two keys, filter keys. And if there's something wrong with your keyboard, we have what's called the on-screen keyboard, which will allow you to actually enter in the information as in what's called a virtual keyboard. Now that you are signed in, you will see the desktop. This is the basic overview of your PC. From here, you can open all of your file and folders and your applications here. You'll see some icons at the bottom of your screen. This is called the taskbar. If you look in the lower left, you will see a start button. From here, you can open the start menu. This will display all of your apps, games, programs, etc. that are installed on your PC. All of these apps are alphabetically ordered, so it is relatively simple to find what you're looking for. If you're looking for a particular file or picture, then you'll want to open Windows File Explorer. Look for the icon that looks like a file folder and click on it. As you can see, you can find folders with pictures, music, etc. If you've saved something to your computer, then you can always find it here. Just double click on the item you want to open. If the icons are too small to see easily, you can adjust the size to fit your needs. At the top, you will see a tab called View. Click on it and you will see that you have the option of extra small, small tiles, large icons, medium icons, extra large icons. On that subject about size, you can also adjust the desktop icons and the text as well. To do this, right-click on the desktop, then scroll down to find Display Settings. To change that, go to Scale and Layout, and then just choose the text size you are comfortable with. If you're looking for a particular file, you do not need to worry if you cannot remember in which file that you stored it in. Merely go to the search on the taskbar, and if you start typing it in, it will appear in the search suggestions. Click on to open the file after that. The two most commonly used typing programs are Word and Notepad. There are several ways to open them, and I'm going to go over what I think is the simplest and the fastest. It's just type in what you're looking for. For instance, Notepad. Now, the second way is through the Start menu. If we were looking for Word, you would just scroll down to W, and Word's there. Now, for Notepad, you have to take an extra step. It's in Windows Accessories, and right here. Now, if you are going to be using Notepad a lot or Word, merely right-click on it, and you have the ability to pin it to the Start menu, or you can pin it to the taskbar, which would put it down here. To connect to the internet, just go to the lower right-hand corner of the taskbar. You'll see an icon that looks like a globe. Double-click on it. Click on your internet connection. And click Connect. Now, if it is password protected, you'll need to enter the passwords when prompted. After that, you just connect. You'll know that you're connected to the internet when the globe becomes this little beam of sound. So, let's surf the internet. Windows 10 comes with Windows Edge pre-installed as the default web browser. Now, up here is the URL bar, the address bar. It's given a bunch of different names. Whatever website you wish to go to, you merely type in the web address. The Windows Club offers excellent articles on how to get the most out of Edge, and we'll be doing more videos on it in the future. So now, it's time to shut down your computer. The simplest way to do that is simply click on the Windows icon in the lower left-hand corner, like we were going to open a program. You'll see this little power icon. As you can see, you have the options of sleep, hibernate, shut down, and restart. You want to click on shut down. Now, there are tons of other things that you can learn to get the most out of your Windows 10 computer. It is an amazing device with an amazing platform that is only going to evolve and improve with time. For that, we offer countless articles at our website, thewindowsclub.com. You can also subscribe to our YouTube channel, where we are always adding new videos to help. If you have any questions, post a question in the comment below, and we will do our best to help you maximize your Windows experience. Thanks for watching this video, and have a great day.